JavaScript, an object-oriented client-side scripting language created by Brendan Eich in 1995 to create dynamic websites. And the fun fact is that the first version of JavaScript was created in just 10 days. Yep, here I cannot complete a single project in 10 days and this guy created a language in just 10 days. Anyway, some people confuse Java with JavaScript. Despite its name, JavaScript and Java are totally different. It was mainly named for marketing reasons at the time because of Java's popularity. Currently, 99% of all websites use JavaScript. So, if you want to be a web developer, you must know about JavaScript. Thanks to various JS frameworks, JavaScript can also be used to create mobile and desktop applications and even games. You can run JS code even in your web browser. Just open developer tools by pressing Ctrl+Shift+I or by right-clicking and selecting the Inspect button. From here, click on this console icon and then you can write any JavaScript code you want and you will see output in this console. For example, console.log hello world and we see hello world printed. But who codes in the web browser? Not me. Do you? To run JS code in your favorite code editor, you need to install Node.js in your computer. Node.js is a runtime environment that runs JavaScript code. Think of it like a Python interpreter. We use it to run Python code. In the same way, Node.js is used to run JavaScript code. To install Node.js, visit Node.js website, click on the download button and then download the installer for your respective operating system. After that, run the installer and install Node.js on your computer. And now, you are ready. A JavaScript file ends with .js extension. Let's write a simple statement to print hello world. To run your JavaScript code using Node.js, type node and then your file name. And we see hello world printed in our terminal. Writing comments in JavaScript is the same as in most other programming languages. There are two types of comments, single line and multi-line. To write a single line comment, we use /2 and then the comment that we want to write. For multi-line comment, the comment starts with /*, and ends with */. And between these, we can write anything and all of it will be treated as a comment. Declaring variables in JavaScript is also easy. But there are three ways to declare a variable. First, using the var keyword, we write var and then the variable name and then the value. And if I will do console.log and the variable name, I will see the value of that variable. Next is using the let keyword. The syntax is same, we just use let and then the variable name and then the value. And after that, using the const keyword, we use const, variable name and then the value. Well, but what's the difference between these three? If we declare a variable using the var keyword and try to redeclare the same variable, we won't have any issues. Everything will work fine. But if we use the let keyword and try to redeclare a variable using the let keyword, we will get an error. That is, identifier myName1 has already been declared. So that means we cannot redeclare a let variable. But we can change the value of the already declared variable. For example, here I changed the value of myName1 to stranger and I see stranger printed. By the way, we can also change the value of the variable declared using the var keyword. Moving on to the const, if we redeclare a const variable, we will get an error, so we cannot redeclare a const variable. And if we try to change the value of the const variable, then also we will get an error because we cannot change the value of a constant. So we cannot redeclare or change the value of a variables declared using the const keyword. Moving on to the control statements, there are four common control statements in JavaScript. First, if statement, then if else statement, then if else if statement, and the last one, switch statement. Writing an if statement is so easy. We write if and then in parentheses the condition that we want to check and in curly braces the code. If the condition is true, the code in curly braces will be executed. For example, here temperature is 75, so this condition, if temperature is greater than 70 is true and we see it is warm outside printed. You may notice here that I'm using semicolons. Well, semicolons are not mandatory in JavaScript because the JS engine automatically adds semicolons when we run our code. However, it is good to add semicolons because sometimes the JS engine can make mistakes. Anyway, back to our if statement. We can add else statement to our if statement like this, else and then curly braces. And then the code to run when the else statement is executed. Here, if the if condition is false, the code in else statement will be executed. For example, if I change the value of temperature to 55, this condition that temperature is greater than 70 becomes false. So the code in else statement, that is, it is cold outside, is printed. We can also add an else if statement by writing else if and then the condition in parentheses. For example, else if temperature is greater than or equal to 50, and then the code in curly braces. For example, printing, it is moderate outside. Now, if I change the temperature again to 55, here what will happen? First, the if condition will be checked. Is temperature greater than 70? No. So, the else if statement will be checked. Is temperature is greater than or equal to 50? Yes, temperature is greater than 50. So, the code in else if statement will be executed. If the condition of else if turns out to be false, then the code in else statement will be executed. Sometimes, having multiple else if statements can be quite confusing. So, if we need to compare the value of single variable multiple times, instead of else if statement, we can use switch statement to avoid confusion. Writing a switch statement is very easy. First, we write switch and then the variable whose value we want to compare in parentheses. Here, we want to compare the value of weather condition, so we will write weather condition in parentheses. And after that, in curly braces, our cases, that means the different values of our variable. For example, case sunny. That means if the value of weather condition is sunny, what to do? We will print wear sunglasses and we will break out of the switch statement. That's why we are using break statement. And same like that, we can have multiple cases. For example, if the weather condition is rainy, we are printing take an umbrella and so on. We can also have a default case, which means if none of these cases match, the default case will be executed. For example, right now, the value of weather condition is snowy. So, wear a warm coat is printed. But if I change the value of weather condition to foggy, then none of these cases will match because we only have sunny, rainy and snowy. So, the code in default case is executed. And this is how switch statement works. There are six different types of loops in JavaScript. The first is for loop. For loop is used to run a block of code multiple times. Writing a for loop is very easy. First, we write for. And then in parentheses, we declare one variable, for example, I equals to 0. This variable is responsible for running our code multiple times. After that, we write the condition, for example, I is less than 5. So this for loop will run until the value of I is less than 5. And after that, we can write I++, which means after the code is executed once, the value of I will be incremented. And the code to run in curly braces. Here, we are simply printing the value of I. So if I will run this code, 0 to 4 is printed because when value of I becomes 5, I is less than 5 condition becomes false and the for loop ends. After this, we have while loop. While loop runs the given code as long as the condition is true. Writing a while loop is so simple. We write while and then the condition in parentheses. For example, I is less than 5. While I is less than 5, what we will do is print the value of I and then we will increase the value of I using the I++. We see 0 to 4 printed because when the value of I becomes 5, the condition becomes false and our while loop ends. Next, we have do while loop. Do while loop guarantees that the given code will run at least once. To write a do while loop, first we write do and then the code in curly braces and then while and then the condition. Here, first the code will be executed and then the condition will be checked. Is j is less than 5? No, it is not, so it won't run again. That's why we see only 10 printed in our terminal. Next is for each loop. It is used to access each element of an array. For example, this is a movies array. And if I want to access each element of this array, I will write the array name dot for each. This for each takes a function. So we will define a function using the function keyword. And in parentheses, we will pass a variable. Since we are storing movie name, let our variable name be movie. And because of this, every element of our array will be treated as a movie variable. And in curly braces, we write the code. For example, printing movie and then the value of the movie variable. And all the movies are printed. Next, we have for in loop. It is used to access each key of an object. For example, I've got person object. To access each key, what I will do is I will write for and then I will declare a variable named key. And then the keyword in and then the object name. After that, in curly braces, the code to run. Here we are printing the key and then the value of that key in person object. And we see all the keys and their values. The last loop is for off loop. It is used to access the elements of an array very easily, unlike for each loop. To write a for off loop, we write for and then we declare a variable, for example, var movie and then the off keyword and then our array name. Here, every element of an array will be treated as a movie variable. And after that, in curly braces, we can write our code like printing the movie name. And we see all the movie names. Next, we have functions. In simple words, a function is a group of statements. To declare a function in JavaScript, we use the function keyword and then the function name and then opening and closing parentheses and then the code to run in curly braces. So here we are just printing addition function. To call a function, we write the function name and then opening and closing parentheses and addition function is printed. We can call the function as many times as we want. So if I will call the function 2 times, we see addition function printed 2 times. This makes our code reusable. We can also pass values to our function. For example, here in parentheses, I am passing the variable named a and b, and then I will print the addition of a and b since our function name is add. Now, when calling the function, if I will pass two values like 60 and 9, then 60 will be treated as variable a and 9 will be treated as variable b, and we will see addition of a and b.